Hi everyone, and thank you for watching me creating the Earth. In the thumbnail you've already seen how the final result basically looks like, and in this video I'm going to show you how I actually came to the point that it looked like it looked. And for those of you who've joined me for my realism paintings and drawings, please bear with me, they will come. I'm still in a way bound by Christmas, so I cannot show you the projects before Christmas to not spoil or ruin any surprises. So more is to come after Christmas for sure, and until this I will give you some insight in my other side of my artsy life by these acrylic pourings and stuff that I do in between. So coming back to this project, this was again a commission which was not for Christmas but for a lovely friend couple that I have, and I'm really really grateful that they asked me to create this because it was just an amazing experience. You might have seen my other video when I did such a large canvas just recently, where I did these flip cups and dirty pours which looked like a tentacle whatsoever thing in the end. It was the first canvas of this size that I did, and it was, as there was no real structure to it, a bit unpredictable what the end result is going to be. And for my taste it was not calm enough, so it was too colorful and too hectic in the picture itself, so not basically my taste, but that was actually the thing that my client wanted to achieve and wanted to have, so she was pretty happy with the result, and so I was happy with the result. In this project here, it was my task to pour the earth, which was an amazing cool idea. I've never done this before and I was instantly in love with the concept of doing this. And another good thing for me, it was supposed to have more structure, though I really was able to see right from the beginning how the end result is going to be, or at least I hoped it to be. Just a small side note at the very beginning, this video will be again a bit sped up at some of the parts or most of the parts, because otherwise I would not be able to show you the entire project in the time that we have, and I did not want to have it longer than 15 to 20 minutes overall. So some parts are sped up, but I made it that way that you can still see everything that I did and follow actually my process here. So what I did, once I had my plan made and I knew the size of the earth pour that they wanted to have for their home, I just got myself a canvas, which is a good starting point, isn't it? And for this one I used the gallery wrap canvas, so this is just a thicker one. It has a 4 cm thickness, which I thought will also look cool when you hang it onto the wall, because it was not to be supposed to be framed. So a thicker canvas looks cool in this size hanging on the wall. And I was right, it really looks cool with the thicker frame. So what I did, I sketched my earth and I thought about doing an underpainting, because I was not sure if I can cover really every spot of the canvas with the acrylic pour paint, and I wanted to give me some, a backup plan, so to speak. So just that every part of the canvas is covered in case I miss an area and otherwise the white of the canvas would have shown through, or due to the silicone that there are some thinner paint layers and the canvas is going to shimmer through a bit. I wanted to try in a way to avoid this, so I made the underlayer, and it also gave me a bit of a confidence because I could already see, well, where the colors go. So if my color scheme that I intended to do in the end, for the continents at least, will have a genuine look and will look nice in the end. I of course did not want to do this photorealistic or such, as there is no way to do this in the pouring. I wanted to be the continents like more colorful. So just something to look at and have fun looking at it. So I did not want to use just green and browns and some blues as the original Earth actually looks from space. No, I wanted it to be a bit more colorful and used the entire rainbow color palette. But you will see later in the end. So once I had my underpainting done, I stood before it and thought, well, Michael, this looks already nice, so good job so far. And the whole underpainting thing took me about an hour, I think. So this was quite quickly done, and I already liked the result, and if I could make this color scheme happen for the pour itself, I thought I would be pretty happy with the end result. But until this project is done, the hardest part is still going to come. First things first, colors had to be mixed. And I again filmed my color mixing for you in case you want to see it. These are the colors that I used for this project, which are again my Artina colors. And if you wonder which colors or materials I've actually used, I started the Amazon affiliate program and I put you all the links below in the description. So if you're curious which materials I've used, you can just click the links. It will guide you to the German Amazon site where I actually order everything from. I am in contact with Amazon to see if I can also get an affiliate access for the American page so that I can make links for the German and for the American site. As long as, of course, the Amazon.com page has the same products as I can order here, then I will make a double link. Otherwise, the German link will also work for you and you just have to wait longer to receive it at the end. But I've contacted them just yesterday, so it will take 1-2 days, I guess, until I have an answer. And I will let you know in the video description later, or I change it, you will see. So far, if you want to see what I use, feel free to click, and if you order it, you will help my channel as well. And if you have any questions besides these, just write me in the comments and I'll be happy to assist you. So again, back to the colors. These are my Etina colors, and I also use some floor tool just to stretch the colors, increase the volume. I also added some silicone because I want to have cells, and due to the size of the project, I want and need to have quite many cells. So I added some silicone to each color. The colors that I'm going to use the most, of course, is the blue, the turquoise and the white for the ocean. This is the reason why I just used a larger cup for those. There is nothing special compared to the other colors which I'm going to use for the continents. It's just the amount of the color that I'm going to use. And once my colors were mixed, I again positioned me in front of the canvas, and I think I was staring at it for 15 minutes, not knowing how to begin and what to do, because I was a little scared to ruin the whole thing. So yeah, after a couple of minutes I just thought, well, you see how it goes when you start. In worst case, you can just wipe it off and start over again, which I hoped will not happen. And lucky me, it did not happen. And for the very beginning, I was wondering if I should start with the continents or with the ocean part. As the ocean part was supposed the most tricky ones and the largest areas, I went for the ocean part first, because if I'm going to fail with the ocean, there was no reason to continue with the continents. I thought the continents are going to be a bit easier because of the smaller sizes and their shape in a way. So they are more like single dirty pores which are in more way separate from each other. The ocean nevertheless is one large interconnected part which has to be genuine and fit together and should look somewhat like one piece. So I went for the ocean part first, and to give me some kind of zone where the color is supposed to flow to in a way, I decided to put some of the blue color first as some kind of second underpainting. So I just used a brush, used my blue color and brushed over the area where the ocean was supposed to be in the end, just because to have the colors flow on this area and not to go too much over the border of the continents. Because, you know, I don't know if you have this feeling as well, that you always wish to have a pause and freeze button when you do dirty pours and pours in general. Because whenever I do them, I have moments where I think, oh, this looks awesome. This has to stay now like it is. So please pause, freeze, paint, don't move anymore. It does move again and more and changes the whole thing again. And this is something I always have when I do these voiceovers and video edits. At almost every painting that I do in these techniques, I have moments in the footage where I think, oh, this looked way prettier than the end result, and this, oh, this was so cool, and then it was gone. So I think you have experienced this yourself, and it's always a struggle finding the perfect end result. Yeah, same here, but worse. It was really a struggle in the beginning. And as you can see here, I more or less started with the lighter and whiter areas, which were supposed to resemble the Arctic zones. And therefore I just mixed my paints in a cup, like a dirty pour in general, and poured it over the canvas, which I thought will give it a genuine look and will look cool and create cells. But it was way too much color, which I did not really expect. And I hope that the blue base color that I painted onto it will in a way stop the color from flowing over the continents, which it did not because it was too much of the color. And so the struggle already began. Until I decided that pouring might not be the best idea to control the whole thing, and I really decided to just do swipes. Because the swiping technique is, as far as I know and as far as I experienced so far, the best and most controllable way to create a certain pattern within the paint and to make it stay where it actually was supposed to stay. Of course it flows a bit anyways, as it's still paint and much more paint than you will need in a way to paint a canvas, but it is not that much color that it just flows everywhere. And so I decided to continue with the swipes, and this is the best method I could find to, in a way, carve the ocean and create the ocean. And I wanted it not to be a one solid color. I wanted to have some color transitions in there where the ocean is in a way a bit deeper than in other parts. I wanted to be a bit lighter on the continents where the water is becoming a bit more shallow. And this was the way how I gradually, in a way, built the ocean part. And once this was done, I really was amazed how cool it looked already. There were areas in the ocean that looked really stunning and awesome. Especially the upper right corner looks cool, like an electric kind of effect. I really loved this area. There are many areas in the ocean that I really loved already, but this one was and still is my top favorite. When the ocean was done, and I was pretty happy with this part, the continents were going to be poured. And for this, again, I made the underpainting to make the paint in a way stay where it was supposed to stay. And I thought flip cups are a cool idea to make this happen. And I created my small flip cup. It is really a tiny cup, so not that much color, but in a way still way too much color. And I flip cupped the US and Canada. And it worked in a way, so the results were coming through, I had cells, the color was spreading around, but then, and you can see this here in the video because it's a sped up version again, it did not stop to flow, and I really completely lost shape of the US, which didn't appear to me while I was working on the other continents, but having watched it afterwards, after a couple of minutes when I just had a look at the US, it completely lost shape and went over to the ocean part, which I really did not want to have and did not like. So I more or less just scraped most of the paint away and put it into the cup again. It has an ugly gray brown color, so I just put it away because I could not reuse it and decided to do a swipe there as well, which worked way, way better and I could control the result. And when the shape of the US was recreated, I also fixed the water area, which was destroyed by the paint as well. So I hope that this was not visible, that I was fixing it, but I think I did a good job and it was not that visible that I had to, yeah, re-swipe the ocean areas. So it still looks like a part of the entire ocean pour, anyway. And for the other continents, I basically did just the same thing. So I added my colors and swiped them together, added some white here and there to just give it a more contrasty look to it. I wanted the colors in the middle zone to be more like yellowish, greenish, like the real Earth in a way is, and the other parts to be a bit more of a darker color, like the violet that I've used here, just in a way to guide the eyes to the center of the piece. Because as the poles and the arctics are quite light, I did not want to have your eyes flow out of the image. So besides the white and lighter colors of the poles, I went for a darker color on top of the continents and in a way also on the bottom part, in a way, and wanted to have it lighter in the center as there's more sand and desert scenes, yeah, going on the planet, and so I thought this might look cool. And for my taste, it really looks cool in the end. I like the color scheme, I like the result. I lost a bit of the shape for some of the continents, and I could not recreate it as I intended in the first place, but I was fine with it. It was not supposed to be a photorealistic recreation of the Earth, you just should get the impression of it, and I think this is something I've managed creating. So most of the continents do not have the perfect correct shape, and there are many islands, for example, are missing. So if you are from a country or island that is missing on this pour, please don't blame me. I couldn't add too many details, as you might imagine. So once the entire project was done, it was time to let it dry. And as this was a swipe and not a completely dirty pour like it was on my first large project, the entire drying did not take nearly as long as the other project did. So because of the swipe, there was way, way less paint onto the canvas. And so drying here took only about 1.5 days to have everything completely dried. The paint on the continents was a bit thicker than on the ocean, so these took a bit longer to dry. But overall, it was just 1.5 days and not 3 to 4 days, which it was for the very large amount of paint for the flip cup pour. Which was really a cool thing, because having this size stored in your flat and having it covered to not have any dust particles fall onto it, it's not that easy. So I was pretty happy that it dried that quickly. And for almost all the paint, it's in the end dried darker than it was when it was wet, of which I was a bit afraid for especially the darker colors in the northern area of Russia. So I wondered if there's going to be enough contrast compared to the ocean part, and that the violet color actually comes through in the end and just not looks like black or so. And although it dried darker, it still looked like violet, so which was cool, and the entire end result was pleasing to me. So I was really happy about it, I varnished it, and of course I made some photos for you, because the original was already picked up yesterday and is now hanging in their homes, which is so awesome. I think that wraps up everything that I did for this project, and I do not want to have this video to become too long, to not in a way bore you, or yeah, just to make it not uninteresting in the end. And I really hope you liked the result. I had such an amazing time making it and I really loved the result. I was happy about it. If you have any questions, please make sure to leave them in the comments as usual. I'm always happy to receive some feedback or assist if there are any questions. If you're new to my channel and have not yet subscribed, I would be happy to have you join my group here and subscribe to my channel. Please also give me a thumbs up if you liked my video, if you liked the idea, if you liked the result. Besides this acrylic pouring, I also do some realism drawings, paintings, as I mentioned in the very beginning, which will come after Christmas again. I have plenty of projects done, but cannot show them yet. So bear with me. Thank you again for watching, and until the next video, I wish you a great day. Bye bye.